on a second. All right, we are live. So hello, this is Jeremy Bailey from theenvironmentguy.com, and today is, it says right here, on a second. It's Friday, July 31st. All right, and it's the third live stream session of this. Sorry, I'm going to turn the audio down just a little bit. I know so it was quiet yesterday, so I wanted to put it up a little bit to be more audible. But this is the third live stream for a 2-week project doing a. I know a test for as an application for a local studio working for games, this is where we are so far. The first day we went over all the reference materials, we read over the description or guidelines for the project, and yeah, that's basically it. After the first day I modeled a number of little pots here. I think there's another one. Yeah, there's another one right here that I modeled, for the second stream, which was yesterday, I went through the modeling of all these pillars, as well as some of these arches, and then last night, off the video, I put together this little structure here just to see how everything was working together. I was questioning yesterday how I should go about putting something over these arches. I think I'm going to make a few pieces like this. I put together this little, as you can see, it's just a few one-offs so that we can put a wall over that arch and not have the wall go through there. But that's where we currently are at. Now today we need to make some more wall pieces as well as some structural elements, so I'm going to be looking for making some windows. I think those are going to be pretty simple. Windows, walls, ground. I don't know if I'm going to go into modeling more terrain type stuff. I want to do some rocks. There's lots that needs to be done still. This is still quite early in the game. So let's get started. I have duplicated a number of objects here. So I have my four planters there. So all this stuff's duplicate. I was just messing around with this. You know, it's looking all right. Let's clean it up here before we begin. Delete that. Don't need. I have that pillar right there. Get rid of those. Pieces there. And behind here, so maybe I can just, I'm going to move that to a different layer and hide that layer there. So in the back here we have our scale. So this is our grid. When we're modeling, we snap to the sections so that everything is the correct size, so that these building blocks can go together like Lego pieces when you're ready. So let's start off by looking at our reference material that I collected a few days ago. Let's see, what should we do? So we're looking for walls. That's a pretty low resolution picture. Let's take a look at what the studio gave me. For reference material. So our walls, they seem fairly flat. I do notice that there is like pipes and wires, which is pretty cool. Interesting thing about Italy is because like a lot of these towns, the buildings are all antique. So they weren't made with electricity originally. So they have to put all their wires and pipes on the outside of the buildings, which I think is really cool. I like exposed wires and such. So that's something that we're gonna wanna have on our walls. Our walls need to include some decorative pieces. You notice that there's like things, I don't know, like above these windows there's like that triangular piece. There's that same triangular piece there. So some decorative pieces like that. There's like borders or little, I know what you call those. They're like carved. Well, okay, in America, it would be made of wood, and it'd be like a carved wooden decorative piece. But here, it's like plaster or something similar to plaster. So we need to make some of those decorative pieces that go on the wall. We need to make those pipes and wires. We need to, of course, the wall itself is just like a just a flat plane, or I'm going to make it double-sided, or double-sided in that it's going to be a cube, not visible by both sides of a plane when it's in the game engine. What else do we have here? Yeah, I think that's it. Yeah, the windows are pretty straightforward. They're also a square. What I'll have to do is make the wall pieces and then make a wall piece with a window piece in it. And the reason why we're going to do that instead of just making a window piece separate from the wall piece is that we wanted a space behind the window so that when we're in a game, it doesn't look like the window is merely of a flat surface with a texture on it. We want to be able to see something inside the buildings. It gives the scene a little bit more depth, a little bit more interesting and believable that way. See, another part of the wall, we're gonna have to make these wrought iron. I don't know what those are. I think that's for holding plant pots. You can't really see it that well here. Well, you can see it up top. But yeah, we need to make some of that, which is going to be interesting. I'm not sure if I'm going to make that just by regular polygonal modeling or if I will use curves. Because curves can work well for that as well. It's not something that seems to get used very often these days, curve modeling. So what else? What else is on these walls? Yeah, maybe I'll make some more planters. Those planters don't need a lot of detail because they're high up. It's not a place where I expect the character to be going. In the scene that I'm making, I expect the character to primarily be on ground level. And I do have some surfaces, like, you see there's this metal thing here. I have modeled something similar to that. Show it to you in my scene. So I have some stuff like that, which, character will be able to walk on. Yeah, I need to make some steps onto this as well. So that's something to consider. And I think I'm going to leave it at that for now. I think that'll be enough for this live stream. Of course, there's lots of other stuff behind the scenes that needs to be done. So let's get started. I'm just going to. Where should I move that? Yeah, I'll just minimize it. Open up our 3D modeling toolkit, and here we are. I've already made a size or a block for a wall. It's two heights up, so, and one width across with our grid there. So let's start by, well, I think we need a simple piece like that, like just a flat piece. That would be good. So maybe what we'll want to do is decide on a proper wall thickness. I'm not convinced that what I have right now is thick enough. If we look in our reference material, that looks pretty thick there. I mean, I'd say that's at least a foot of thickness. And no, those arches are going to be a bit thicker than the wall, but see. There's somewhere else that we can look. Like up here, see the windows, how they're inside the wall a bit, they're back. So we can see that clearly this is not a thin wall. It is fairly good depth. So I want to make sure our pieces represent that. Something like that. And this capsule shape here, that's our scale reference for the character that will be running around in the engine. So that's a pretty decent thickness there. I think that's good. And we need to set... Oh wait. Okay, there. Our point of origin's already been set. Let's snap it up there so that we can match that thickness on the top. There we go. Very nice. Figure that out. So now that our thickness is done, we have blocks that we can build up with quite easily. So decorative pieces, I want to start with those borders because those borders are going to be fairly straightforward to make. So what I'm thinking is, see, I need to change my snap settings here. There we go. So I think what I'll do is use a full wall piece and then build the border on top. I mean, that's one way to do it. The other way is just to make our wall and then put... Maybe that's what I'll do. See what the proper size for this would be. So if that's a decorative piece there, something like that should be good. And clearly it's coming out too much, so we'll move it back just a little bit. I still think it's a little bit too tall. Put it like that. So what can we make out from this detail here? It's kind of like there's a top flat piece. There's another thing in the center, and it looks like it just angles in. Let's see. So according to that image, it looks like it would be something like that. There, a little decorative piece. We might want to add a bevel to that. Let's see, what can we do with this piece to make it better? We have some excess faces there that we can merge in. I'll deal with that a little bit later though. Back faces, yeah, we can get rid of most of those. Add a little bit of curve there just to make it more interesting. I think that looks a little bit better than just having it completely straight. And so the bevels. I don't think we need a bevel on the top. Because this is going to be up high, the character is not going to be looking down on it like that. Or at least if they are going to be looking down on it, it's going to be from a distance. So it's not a huge concern. So we'll make the bevels just visible from the bottom. Something like that. I think that's good. So with that done, we can do our merging. Merging of the vertices. And that just makes sure that we don't have a lot of excess polys here. There we go. So that's two tries on the back, two on the top. Okay. I don't think I like that though. We have a tiny little face there. That needs to be retopologized. It's hard to get that. If we take that, make the face like there. There to there. Good. I believe that fixes the problem. Make sure we don't have any crazy faces in there. Good. So now what we need to do is set the point of origin. So I'm just going to select a vertex and set origin to, that's not where I intended it to be, cursor to selected, there we go. Good. Now when we use the snap to move this, there, works perfectly. So if I duplicate this, move it along somewhere. Why isn't it snapping correctly? I think it's because it's on the left side and I'm trying to align it by the right. Oh, there we go. There we go. Now it works. So as you can see, we can duplicate it and snap it into place, which is going to make it really easy for building the level in the game engine. So that's one piece. Let's see, is there any other pieces like that? It almost looks like there's a whole bunch of separate pieces. And they're all a little bit different from each other, so maybe what I'm going to do is, so I have that piece, I might want to make some bracket pieces, like angles, so it can go around corners. Let's see, how will I do that? I can take a piece, I think I need to cut it. At a 45 degree angle. There's 26. I'm going to use the boolean. There we go. We can cut it at a 45 degree angle, apply, and let's see, As you can see, it fits on there. Like so. Or it should. Actually, I don't think that's gonna work quite right. Let's try something else. Duplicate it. Move that around by 90 degrees. Put it in the opposite direction. There we go. So it's at a 90 degree angle. And now, I'm going to make a duplicate of that. Join those meshes together. Get rid of these inside faces. And we can start bridging these. So if I select that, I'm pressing the wrong key here. There we go. I think it's that those two edges on the top are just so close together. It's selecting the wrong one. And we can bridge the edge loops like so. And ta-da, 45 degree angle. Now to make the back of this, I'm going to extrude this. Extrude that like there. Face it off on the top and bottom. Excellent. So, we can now get rid of those sides because we don't need it anymore. And that missing gap on top, I don't think that's a big deal. Because what's going to happen is when, well, no, maybe, nah, I changed my mind. I was just going to say we can extrude out this little, at the sides here, so it comes out a little bit, but I figured if I did that, then it wouldn't align up with my grid properly anymore, so we shall do it this way. And this piece here is four sides, so it's okay. Good. And see, we have an end guard on the bottom, so just divide that. And there's, that's a quad on the top. So with that done, now we can set the point of origin. Let's see, where should I put the origin point? I'll just see what it's like if I put it there. Cool. But there is one problem. Maybe it won't be a problem. You know what? If I put it on this side, fine if it just overlaps with the other piece. There we go. That should work perfectly. Voila. I can now angle this by 90 degrees. And I believe we'll need to make a duplicate of this piece and have it scaled by -1. And the reason why we're going to do that is because in the game engine, if you scale something inside out or by a negative number, your normals will be flipped and it won't look proper. So always want to make sure it's going to be proper in the engine. There we go. There. Which is quite nice. I mean, that in itself is like a little area. You can look up, we could, it's almost like a skylight. So we can make all kinds of stuff with that now, which is good. So we have a decorative piece, or I should say pieces, because it's more than one piece. We might want, I'm going to leave it for now. I was going to say we can make different styles of this, but I think one style is enough. We should move on with the next item. So, for our next piece, let's see what we're going to do. We need to make some pipes. Yes. So the pipe should be fairly easy. I think what it'll be. How many sides? I'm gonna start by trying out 8 sides. So for this pipe, we're going to need the straight pieces, like the vertical piece. We're going to need some elbow joints. And if I really want to, I can make some slanted points as well. Maybe something around that scale. Just check out our reference image once more. So yeah, we're gonna need a straight piece for to go traverse along our wall. We're going to need the elbow pieces that connect together. Let it go in right angles to itself, and a few unique, like one-off pieces. Like this part right there is kind of interesting. Maybe there's valves on here somewhere. We're gonna need little connectors to put it onto the wall, and it looks like the wires travel alongside the pipe. So, I'm not sure. We need a little. There's a few things we're gonna have to make. Shouldn't be difficult. Just make sure that's correct height. Very good. And set the shading to smooth. It looks like it's okay. I will need to make sure those ends are hard. There we go. And what else will I need? I was just thinking, I don't know. I forgot what I was doing. But let's make the joint. So I'll duplicate that. Scale it like so. Where is it snapping to? I think the origin is scale. Why is that confusing me? Oh, yes. Okay, I know what I'm going to do now. I'm going to make it so I'm going to make the T-joint like that. Because if we do like a rounded joint on the top, this, because we want it to stick within our unit, we put that on top, and this is going to stick right through it. It's going to look all weird, so we need to bring our joint down like this. And I guess what it will be is a piece a little bit wider like that, and then we'll have another piece sticking out on the side. I think that's how it needs to work. Something like that. I'll put some more details. I think it might need a few more polys, actually. 8 might not be good enough. I'm going to make a new cylinder for this. 8. Try 12. 12 should be plenty for a little detail like this. Put that on top. Good. And also we need to triangulate those end pieces there so it's not n-gons. Something like that. It's good. Next. Actually, maybe do it like this. Okay, and 714. Ooh, that really messed up shading. What I've done here is I've cut out part where the pipe goes. Maybe instead of doing it like that, I should be doing it there. There's a tool in Blender where you just select a whole bunch of vertices and it forms them around as a circle. It's kind of interesting, but I forgot the name of it. I was looking for it on the last stream, but couldn't find it. I also know you can project shapes onto a mesh, cut it that way, but I don't know. Just interesting little tools. Don't really need them right now, but there's all kinds of ways to do this. So now that I have that, that's a curious looking piece. I like it. So what we can do, like, we could cap that off, make a little cap there, and have the pipe continue going vertical, or we could take the cap off and have it going horizontal, or we could just remove the cap onto the top there. That's a possibility. Let's see what it looks like with this pipe. So it appears the pipe fits in there quite well. Which is good. I think it'd be cool if it maybe bulged out a little bit, like it was round. The thing is, my loop cuts probably aren't going to work properly. Oh, let's try it anyways. Could just make some cuts by hand here. Line that up. And then we can take, let's see. Something like that. I don't know. It's an interesting piece. From this distance, it looks fine. I think that's going to be all right. can just, you know, build up our pipes around the way we want it. We might want something else for those pipes. Nice. many? I think I used 12 sides for that. Yep. So I'm making my interpretation of that little thing. Can't really see it there, it's so pixelated, but try and make some interesting looking object to come off there. Hey, what? Where'd it go? Gah. I accidentally made those two objects the same object, scaled it way down. And this name is I'm not sure I like that right there. It's kind of close to that edge. Yeah, it'll be okay. Not the end of the world. Well, I know. I'm gonna change it. It's bothering me. If I just merge that, and then cut the face like so. Good. It's a pretty interesting looking thing. And then that would be where the stuff comes out. Maybe I want to make it so multiple things come out. That'd be cool. I don't think I'm going to cut that into the object. I could. Yeah. Nah. I don't need to cut it in. For this part, scale it like that, 45 degrees. That's kind of cool too. Actually, you know what? Players aren't going to see it right there. What I'll do is duplicate that. Actually, what would be really good here is a curve. I don't think I'll do a curve. This will be sufficient. It's kind of silly to have 8 sides on there now. Maybe what I'll do is just create a new cylinder. Instead of 8, 6. Could probably even get away with 5. Actually, maybe I can enhance the silhouette a little bit. Just give a little bit more difference there. Those ones we can just delete, because that's never going to be seen by the player. This bottom one. that one. There's that bottom one. And on the pipe. Actually, I might want to model that. If I want that pipe to be... Well, actually, come to think of it, there's another similar piece to that right there. Say I made a pipe. What should I do? I think if I do want pipe lying around, I'll just use that piece. So I'm not going to model the... put a little inside there. I'm just going to merge it down. Good. So we have a one-off piece, we have a length of pipe, we have a joint. Now, see, we need connectors so it can be attached to the wall. Let's move this roughly to the distance we would have it from the wall. Maybe something like that. And for connectors, duplicate that pipe. Although once again, I'm thinking I might want more edges. Let's see. Yeah, I think it'll be okay. It's a small object, kind of far away. So what I'm thinking is separating this into two pieces, and have it look like it's clamped together. So I can use the bevel tool. So, move it out like that. Okay, and the cylinder, five sides is good enough. something like that. Nice. I might want to extend these out a little bit more. When we set dress the environment, we're probably going to want to put variance and angle, you know, so everything's not a perfect straight line. So if these are a little bit longer, it gives me some room to rotate the object around and position it without it clearly not being attached to the wall. So that's okay. And maybe I can delete those faces because that's never going to be seen by the player. So that's the pipe. I don't think I need to. Actually, there is one more thing. I want to add wire to some of these pipes. So what I'm going to do is duplicate that pipe and create some things that a wire could possibly be connected to. Isolate that object for a moment. We have a bunch of excess faces. curious design. So with that, to make the wire, I'm going to use Bezier curve. So, now the important thing with this is that it has to line up with itself. There, it's a tileable wire. We may want to make a couple variances of the same wire. So I'll just duplicate it. Quite as many polys on there. Okay. Convert it to a mesh. Appears to be good. Let's make sure it lines up on the bottom. Actually should have done that earlier, but well. And it does. So that piece is good. So the next thing is a few pieces to go along with that wire, such as a connector piece to put multiple wires together, and maybe if we want a wire that's not attached to anything, or a wire that's has a transformer or something connected, you know, we need to make a few things like that. Let's see what's in our picture here. We end with like a jumble of wire. Oh yeah, we need the drainage system from the roof. So the pipes coming down for draining. And the wires that we use for horizontal will be different from the ones that we use for vertical, because horizontal gravity is going to be pulling it down, so it's going to kind of swoop. Or, you know, it's going to sag when it's horizontal, whereas when it's vertical, gravity is pulling it tight, so it's not going to vary so much. So let's duplicate our pipe by 90 degrees. Good. And I shouldn't have. I wish I still had those curves. I got rid of those curves. I wasn't thinking ahead too much. Oh well. It's not a big deal. We can fix that. Here. Sorry if I seem unusually quiet today. I'm just really into making these things. And this one, we need to make, like we did a couple vertical ones, we should probably do like three, maybe even four. I don't think we need that many. Three, just because those dips, because the variance is so much larger than the variance in the vertical one, it's easier to pick out duplicates of the same object. So we need to make more of these objects to keep them unique looking. try to match the thickness with that other wire we made earlier. We're also going to need some more divisions along the length than we did with the vertical. Keep it looking smooth. Probably fine. How many edges is that? 6? Okay, good. That matches the quality of our previous ones. Excellent. So next, let's make sure that this is tileable. Selected. Turn on the snapping. To be, I think it's slightly off, only by the tiniest bit. Why is that? Well, I can fix it once it's converted to polygon. It's not a big deal. Let's make sure that does the same thing on this side. It's gonna work for us. I think it's not snapping right because this isn't being calculated as polygons right now, because it is a curve, but I can judge this from looking at it. That's probably going to be fine. I can make manual adjustments later. Not a big deal. So, or I hope so. What I'll do, so I will duplicate this, convert it to a mesh, and then test this. See if it really is working properly. So, if this end works as well, then it's good. looks like that. So you can definitely see the repetitiveness in there, and that's why we need to make more than one. Let's cover that one. Actually, something I didn't consider. Line up that way. There you go. Okay, it's good. Let's make another variance on this. Maybe too flat. Good. Correctly. Make sure it lines correctly on the other side. And it appears that it does. Maybe what I'll do now. I'll make a length of two of these and see if I need to make a third one or not. Because I haven't set up the sensors here, it's not snapping right, but anyways, that's not what I'm looking for. I already know they line up, so... So basically, that's what the wire is going to look like. That one dip there still looks pretty obvious. I think I'm going to make one more. Just to be absolutely sure it looks unique in game. Okay, that's going to be it for those. So I'm going to save one just to keep that curve, because I'll probably want to use that curve again. Convert those to meshes. There we go. We have two vertical wires that are unique, three unique horizontal wires, and now a few more interesting pieces. I'm thinking a coil of wire. I don't really like the looks of that. Okay. So we need some junctions. It's little boxes, you know, places where wires connect into. We may want a split wire. So if we have a wire going long, we stick the box on the wall, we can use a little split object to connect it to the box. That'll give us more flexibility of where we can place our objects using these assets. I can something like that. Thank you. Really? Why is that not working? It might be because of these N-gons. Try that. Nope, still not working. It's like a hidden face. Ah, that's the problem. That's not supposed to be there. Now it works correctly. Do I want to put a... How can I make this better? To manually cut this. Like so. And then that allows me to get rid of one half of it. That correctly. Well, it's easy to fix. There. Half an icosphere. And with this, just scale that down after I turn off the snapping. And move it into position. So we're at an hour 50 now, so I guess I'm gonna wrap this up pretty soon. Actually went by a lot faster than I did or thought it would. But we got this decorative piece done. We got some angle pieces so we can go around corners. We got pipes, a one-off for the pipe or some interesting thing. We have vertical wires, which are tileable. We have horizontal wires. I'm currently working on some electrical boxes. I got one done here. I'm going to keep working on this on my own right now because I have time to do so. And tomorrow is Saturday, I believe. I may or may not live stream the weekend, but yeah. I'm gonna call that the end for this stream. So, have a good day.